Dear students, in my last lecture, I discussed on high performance concrete. Today, I will throw some light on ferrocement. The concept of use of fibers to reinforce brittle materials dates back to ancient constructions. Built in India using mud walls reinforced with woven bamboo mats and reeds. In the recent form, ferrocement may be considered as a type of thin reinforced concrete construction where cement mortar matrix is reinforced with many layers of continuous and relatively small diameter wire meshes. While the mortar provides the mass, the wire mesh imparts tensile strength and ductility to the material. In terms of structural behavior, ferrocement exhibits very high tensile strength to weight ratio and superior cracking performance. The distribution of a small diameter wire mesh reinforcement over the entire surface and sometimes over the entire volume of the matrix provides a very high resistance against cracking. Moreover, many other engineering properties such as toughness, fatigue resistance, impermeability, etc. are considerably improved. Sometimes conventional reinforcing bars in a skeleton form are added to thin wire meshes in order to achieve a stiff reinforcing case. Then the materials used in the ferrocement. Cement mortar matrix. The ferrocement composite is a rich cement mortar matrix of 10 to 60 millimeter thickness with a reinforcement volume of 5 to 8% in the form of one or more layers of very thin wire mesh and a skeleton reinforcement consisting of either welded mesh or mild steel bars. Normally, Portland cement and fine aggregates matrix is used in ferrocement. The matrix constitutes about 95% of the ferrocement and governs the behavior of the final product. This emphasizes the need for proper selection of constituent materials, their mixing and placing. The choice of cement depends on the surface conditions. To maintain the quality of cement, it should be fresh, of uniform consistency, and free of lumps and foreign matter. Cement should be stored under dry conditions and for as short duration as possible. The fine aggregate, that means sand, which is the inert material occupying 60 to 75% of the volume of the mortar, must be hard, strong, non-porous, and chemically inert. The aggregate should be free from silt, clay, and other organic impurities. The particle sizes of 2.36 mm and above, if present in the substantial quantities, may cause the mortar to be porous. On the other hand, very fine particles, if present in a substantial amount, will require more water to achieve the required workability, thereby adversely affecting the strength and impermeability. The fine aggregates conforming to grading zones 2 and 3 with particles greater than 2.36 mm and smaller than 150 micron removed are suitable for ferrocement. Therefore, sands with maximum sizes of 2.36 mm and 1.18 mm with optimum grading zones 2 and 3 are recommended for ferrocement mixes. Use of fine sand in ferrocement is not recommended. The water content which governs the strength and workability of mortar primarily depends upon the maximum grain size, the fineness modulus, and the grading of the sand. The water used for making mortar should be free from impurities such as clay, loam, acid, salts, vegetables, matters, etc. Plasticizers and other admixtures may also be added for achieving number 1 an improved workability, number 2 water reduction for increase in strength and reduction in permeability, number 3 waterproofing, number 4 increase in durability, etc. In addition, admixtures containing chromium trioxide may be used to prevent galvanic corrosion of galvanized steel reinforcement. Pozzolanas such as fly ash may be added as cement replacement material up to 30% to increase the durability. Mixed proportions. The mixed proportions in terms of sand cement by ratio by mass normally recommended are 1.5 to 2.5. The water cement ratio by mass may vary between 0.35 to 0.6. In order to reduce permeability, the water cement ratio must be kept below 0.4. The moisture content of the aggregate should be taken into account in the calculation of required water. The amount of water can be reduced by the use of appropriate admixtures. The slump of fresh mortar should not be normally exceed 50 mm and 28 days compressive strength of moist cured cubes should be around 35 MPa for most applications. Sand being the principal constituents of ferrocement, its properties have a major influence on the amount of water and hence on the mixed design. Improvements in the grading composition of sand may allow considerable reduction of water requirement. Sand with maximum nominal size less than 2.36 mm or 1.18 mm should be avoided in ferrocement mixes. The mixes should have compositions such that the total absolute volume of cement and fines is about 300 cubic centimeter per liter of mortar. A change in the amount of cement must be accompanied by a corresponding change in that of fines. Then the reinforcement. The skeleton steel frame is made conforming to exactly to geometry and shape of the structure and is used for holding the wire meshes in position and shape of the structures. Skeleton steel. The skeleton steel comprises relatively large diameter, about 3 to 8 mm steel rods, typically spaced at 70 to 100 mm. It may be tight reinforcement or welded wire fabric. The welded wire fabrics normally contain large diameter wires spaced at 25 mm or more. Welded wire fabrics of 3 to 4 mm diameter wires welded at 80 to 100 mm center to center have been successfully used for making skeleton frames for the cylindrical or other ferrocement surfaces where these meshes can be bent easily. They provide better and uniform distribution of steel and save time in fabrication but may cost a little more when compared to mild steel bar frames. In the case of structures where higher stresses may occur, as in case of boats, barges, etc., the mild steel bars provided to act as skeleton steel are also counted as reinforcement, imparting structural strength, stiffness, and durability. However, a minimum possible size of bars should be used in order to obtain the effect of wire meshes and hence the composite effect. The spacing of the skeletal transverse and longitudinal steel bars of diameter of 5 to 7 mm depends upon the type of and shape of structures. In case of boat hulls, a spacing of 75 to 100 mm is adequate, whereas in water tanks, beams, etc., the spacing may vary between 200 to 300 mm. The bars are mostly tied with binding wires but can also be welded. The reinforcement should be free from dust, loosed rust, coating of paint, oil, or similar undesirable substances. Then the wire mesh. The wire mesh consisting of galvanized wire of diameter 0.5 to 1.5 mm spaced at 6 to 20 mm center to center is formed by welding, twisting, or weaving. The specific mesh types include woven or interlocking mesh, woven cloth, and welded mesh. The welded wire mesh may have either hexagonal or square openings. Meshes with hexagonal openings are sometimes referred to as chicken mesh. The hexagonal wire mesh is cheaper but structurally less efficient than the mesh with square openings because the wires are not oriented in principal stress directions, that is maximum principal stress. Moreover, the rectangular meshes have better rigidity when placed or tied over the skeleton frame and do not sag during placing the mortar. Meshes with square openings are available either in the form of welded wire mesh or in the oven form. The welded wire mesh have a higher Young's modulus and hence provides a higher stiffness and less cracking in the early stages of loading. On the other hand, oven wire meshes are a little more flexible and easy to work with than the welded meshes. In addition, welding anneals the wire and limits the tensile strength. Generally, the square oven meshes consisting of 1 or 1.5 mm diameter wires spaced at about 12 mm are preferable. Wire meshes are also available in the galvanized form. Galvanizing, like welding, reduces the tensile strength. However, to control cracking, the welded wire fabric should be used in combination with wire meshes. The minimum yield strength of wire used in fabric should be 415 MPa for plain wires and 500 MPa for deformed wires. The wire diameter should be less than 12 mm, except in case of very thick plates. Then, expanded metal lath is formed by slitting thin gauge sheets and expanding them in the direction perpendicular to the slits. Expanded metal offers strength approximately equal to that offered by welded wire mesh. However, they result in a steeper composite, resulting in reduced crack widths at the early edges of loading and provide better impact resistance. It is unsuitable in the application involving sharp curves. Reinforcing bars may be used in the combination with wire meshes for relatively thick ferrocement elements. The minimum possible size of bars should be used in order to obtain the effect of wire meshes and hence the composite effect. Addition of steel fibers to ferrocement seems to enhance the properties considerably. They assist in distributing cracks and hence may allow the use of heavier meshes. Then we can go for the application of this ferrocement. Due to the very high percentage of well distributed and continuously running steel reinforcement, the ferrocement behaves as steel plates. As already discussed, its cracking resistance, ductility, impact, and the fatigue resistance are higher than those of concrete. In addition, the impermeability of ferrocement products is far superior to that of ordinary reinforced concrete products. Ferrocement combines easy moldability of concrete to any desired shape, lightness, tenacity, and toughness of steel plates. Due to very high tensile strength to weight ratio and superior cracking behavior, the ferrocement is an attractive material for light and watertight structures and other portable structures such as mobile homes. The other specialized applications include water tanks, silos, बीन्स, बोट हल्स, बायोगैस होल्डर्स, पाइप्स, फोल्डेड प्लेट्स एंड शेल रूफ्स, फ्लोर यूनिट्स, कियोस्क्स, सर्विस कोर यूनिट्स, विंड टनल्स, मॉड्यूलर हाउसिंग, स्विमिंग पूल एंड परमानेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ कंक्रीट कॉलम्स. The advantages can be summarized as: ferrocement structures are thin and light, therefore a considerable reduction in self weight of structures and hence in foundation cost can be achieved. A 30% reduction in dead weight on supporting structure, 15% saving in steel consumption and 10% in roof cost. Ferrocement is suitable for manufacturing the precast unit which can be easily transported. The construction technique is simple and hence does not require highly skilled labor, even for complicated forms. Partial or complete elimination of formwork is possible. Ferrocement construction is easily amenable to repairs in case of local damage due to abnormal loads such as impact loads. Thank you.